Cindy Birdsong left, and I'm sorry, Diana left, and Jean Terrell took her place.
I remember
and then
that.
Cindy left, Linda Lawrence took her place, and then Jean and Linda left, and I replaced Jean, and Cindy came back, reclaiming her spot from Linda Lawrence. So it was Mary, Jean, I'm sorry, Mary, Cindy, and myself.
Okay.
And then Cindy left one for the last time, and Susaye came in as the last Supreme.
Does anybody have a pen so I can write
this? I'm so confused at this point.
You know, the only reason I brought it up is because there are people listening and probably people in the chat room that are not as familiar with the Supremes as I am, so they don't even know that there were other incarnations other than Mary, Flo, and Diane.
Yeah, I didn't. Like when I came in today.
Okay.
And I've listened to a lot of them, but
wow,
I never really.
There?
Yeah.
Well, I came in 1973, and then Susaye came in 76, and in 77, mid 77, that's when Mary decided to go solo.
Yes.
And so Susaye and I were continuing on as the Supremes, and we were going to get Joyce Vincent from Tony Orlando and Dawn.
Oh, I remember her. Yeah.
Oh, absolutely, a dear
She's
friend
gorgeous.
Of mine. Yes, she is.
Mm.
And then Edie came down from Motown that they, since there was no original member in the group, they were going to retire the Supreme.
Name.
The name.
Sure.
How was, because that must be a scary feeling of, you know, because both of you had careers before the Supremes.
Absolutely.
But going into a group that was already well established, but then when, you know, Mary leaves, and then it's like, well, what do we do? How do we reinvent?
Mm-hmm.
So that's another scary moment. So what is it like going into the Supremes for the first time and knowing that they've already been established as the new member?
Wow.
It's daunting.
Yes, it is.
But you realize you're in good company.
Right.
Very
right.
You know, it's quite an honor to have been part of something that is such a legend.
Mm-hmm.
And no pressure, huh?
Not at all.
But,
not at all.
You know, we were each selected to do this specific thing.
Mm-hmm.
And it was because of our background, because of our experience, because of our possibilities.
Mm-hmm.
As a three, you know, as the three Supremes.
Mm-hmm.
And Mary Wilson and Scherrie Payne and I worked together as the last configuration of the Supremes.
Yes.
After Mary left, we spoke to Barry Gordy, and we were going to get Sarita Wright.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we were licensed the name Supreme.
Right.
Yes. Let me stop you right there.
Okay.
So for those of y'all that do not know who Sarita Wright is, Sarita Wright, I believe at one point, was married to Stevie Wonder,
yes, she
and
was.
She collaborated many times with Michael Jackson on some songs.
Yes.
So look her up on iTunes. Okay, continue.
and she was the demo voice for all the songs that Diana recorded.
That's right.
Oh,
Sarita did
that
the
I didn't know.
Demo.
That's
okay, so sorry, Susaye. Continue.
No problem. So we went up to Barry Gordy's house, and we sat and talked, and he told us he wanted to be a part of a group called the Super Group with Scherrie, Susaye, and Sarita.
Mm-hmm.
But Billy Preston and Sarita had recorded with You Are Born Again.
Oh,
and
I
as
remember
we
that
all
song.
Know, it became an
it was a monster hit.
Worldwide hit. So it was no point for her to go in a group at that point, which is how we got to where we are right now.
Yes.
We recorded an album together called Partners, Scherrie and Susaye,
and
we produced along with
Eugene McDaniels.
And we produced, we wrote all,
we
the,
wrote
songs,
all the songs,
we arranged the songs, and then of course we sang them.
Mm-hmm,
so that
was
a very unique situation for us.
Yes, it was.
That album came out, and it was basically buried.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it was.
So we know from various DJs we spoke to, and you know, people who were sent the album and then asked to not play it. Because of other things.
Yes.
And we won't go into what the other things were.
No, you can tell us.
That's
no, I'm
no I'll say it for her. You know, back in that day, because I will. Because I used to be a publicist in the record industry, so I'll say this. Back in those days, there was a lot of payola going on. So if somebody didn't want something
true.
To get heard, it didn't get heard.
Right.
That's
for
right.
those reasons.
But
go
let me
ahead,
tell you,
Scherrie.
An incident after Susaye and I were called to do a background session, Quincy Jones called us, and it was Susaye, myself, James Ingram, and this next young man who was just so excited to meet Susaye and me. He said, I just love you and Susaye. I love your new album Partners. And I said, well, I'm honored to meet you too, because he had just gotten a hit. He said, well, every record company in town turned me down, and this young man was Luther Vandross.
I knew you were going to say that.
Yeah.
Oh, who's I'm just kidding.
Okay.
Whatever.
Luther had a hard way to go. He got booed at the Apollo.
No,
what?
No.
Oh, but he did. He did amateur night, and they booed him off the stage. Yes, they did.
Wow.
But he was victorious.
I can't even imagine that.
Yes, he was. He overcame all the odds and became legendary. He just celebrated an anniversary of his a couple of days ago.
Oh, he was so wonderful.
I just want to backtrack a minute. When you asked how did it feel coming into this group, I was in Detroit, and Lamont Dozier was the gentleman I was dating at that time, and he had come out here and saw Mary at a party, and she mentioned that Gene Terrell was leading. They were leaving, and they were looking for a new lead singer, so naturally he suggested me. So Mary called me, and we talked. I sent some pictures and a copy of our album. I was in a group called The Glass House with HDH's company, Holland Dozier Holland's company, Invictus Records. So then Mary called me on a Thursday night. I got on a plane Saturday. But before that, it was like, am I crazy? The Supremes? I can't do it. And my mother sat me down. She said,
and calmed you down.
She gave me that mother pep talk. Okay. And I got on the plane that Saturday. Cindy picked me up at the airport. The next Saturday or Friday, we were in New Mexico at the State Fair.
Oh, wow.
My Lord.
You would have kicked yourself.
And Susaye, how did you end up coming to the group?
Well, I was in Wonderlove. Mm-hmm. I was writing with Stevie Wonder. Mm-hmm. That's when Denise Williams and I were in the group at the same time, along with Shirley Brewer. Mm-hmm. We wrote Free, which became her first million seller.
Love that song.
Yes.
And we also, Stevie and I wrote I Can't Help It at that time for Michael Jackson, which was on his Off the Wall. And I was having a ball. I was in Wonderlove. We were just buds, you know, hanging out. Stevie paid for everything. All we had to do was go to rehearsal 6 days a week. Mm-hmm. Then my mother, glorious woman that she is and was, came to me and said, because she was on the executive board of the Beverly Hills branch of the NAACP, and Bob Jones, who was the head of publicity at that time, they were good friends.
From Motown.
Yes, exactly. Mm-hmm. She said, Bob said, are you interested in being a Supreme? I said, well, something I've never done.
I love the fact that somebody just came to y'all and said, y'all want to be a Supreme? Exactly. Here you go.
Exactly. That shows that. It was
right. But
that's,
I think it's.
That's right.
Daunting.
Love that. Divine intervention.
Divine
for real.
Intervention.
No but you doubt. Have to learn all the choreography, you have to learn all the harmonies, and in such a short time.
Leads.
Everything.
I would just go hide.
There's no time for that.
No, I know. Okay. You can hide, but it won't go away, right?
No, you can run.
Yeah. Oh my God!
So tell us how you guys decided to get together and write and collaborate and come up with partners.
Well, like Susaye said, we went up to Barry's house because they said, well, they had enough solo artists on Motown label already. So he said, well, what can we do? And that's when we sat and played a couple of our songs, original songs we had written, and he came up with the idea of the super group with Sarita, Susaye, and myself. Then, of course, then Sarita went on to have her mega hit with Billy Preston. Yeah. So Suzanne DePass decided, well, you and Susaye can do something together. And Susaye came up with the title Partners. And that's how it evolved.
Now, it was released, was supposed to be released in 79.
Yes, it was.
And it's being re-released now, right?
Yes, it
so
is.
So when is the re-release date for that?
It's out.
Oh,
it's
good.
It's online. You can find it at Amazon. It's doing really well. It's out of Japan. Universal Japan released it.
Okay.
So the fact that the fans lobbied for this for 5 years is so important to us. So absolutely brilliant to us.
Yes.
And Motown decided to put it out there. It's the first time it was ever on CD, and it's been mastered, remastered, remixed lovingly by Andy Scuro, by Kevin Reeves,
George Solomon.
Yes.
So it's on Amazon, but not on iTunes because it's Japan, so it would be on Japan iTunes, not US iTunes, right?
But it's every, you can just Google it.
Yeah.
Google Partners Scherrie and Susaye, and it comes up lots of places. So it's widely available. And we are so overjoyed to get the chance to actually perform this music live. We didn't do that, you see.
Before.
Sure.
Not since 79. This is the first.
So it's
that
quite
must
a
be
treat.
A great feeling.
It's a kick.
Because, you know, a lot of people, they do, you know, the Supremes will never fade away, but there's a lot of people that in this industry you never hear from again.
That's true.
And so, but to be able
that's
to come
nowadays,
back.
Yeah,
it's a blessing, you know.
But now you're coming back and you know, reintroducing a whole new couple generations to this music, and they're loving it.
That's
and that must be a great feeling.
Real music.
It is.
Yeah, real.
I was saying before we came on the air that, you know, people come in and out of this industry all the time. And back in the day when you turned on the radio,
you knew
who was who. Everybody wasn't sounding the same.
That's
they weren't looking the same.
There was no
they didn't have their pans down to their angles. There was no auto-tune.
Auto-tune.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I have to say, Susaye can still hit those same high notes.
Oh, oh wow. Hey, girl. All right.
Okay, now since you did that, since you did that, just brings me to my next question.
Yes.
Since you did that, Free by Denise Williams was one of my all-time favorite songs. As a matter of fact, that song was the first song I ever sang in front of people at a talent show.
How long? I won. Now.
I won the show. But wanted to know, I won. Did you collect?
Yes.
Okay. And yes. So how did that come about? Well, you guys were in Wonder Love.
We were. And Wonder Love, we had Nate Watts on bass. We had Hank Red on saxophone. Michael Cimbello, who wrote such fabulous Flashdance hits.
Mm-hmm. He's
the guitarist, one of the guitarists.
I remember him.
Ben Bridges.
Mm-hmm.
Just an amazing band. My band. And that's what Steve called them. He would come in, he'd be mad because, you know, I was a little bit older than them. I mean, Greg Fillinganes was 19
years
old.
Oh, Lord.
He was a keyboard player.
I know who Greg Fillinganes is.
Yeah, child prodigy.
So what a bad
prodigy.
And Steve was, you know, off sort of being in love and that sort of thing. And, you know, I took full advantage. This is my group of young people.
Mm-hmm.
And we wrote some amazing music during that time. So now tell me, what was the original question?
Now, how did you and Denise collaborate to end up coming up with Free?
Hank Red and Nate Watts started the track.
Mm-hmm.
We were in rehearsal.
Dun, dun, dun,
and
dun,
exactly.
Dun, dun.
And Nisi walked up to the mic and started singing Whispering, because it was a different kind of a vibe. It was more of a Brazilian feel.
Oh.
In his ear. She wrote the whole first verse. And then she says that I came up to her and slipped a note into her hand and said, sing these words. So I had sat there and had written the rest of the lyrics, you know, and that's how we'd collaborate. Wow. We wrote a lot of material together.
That is so cool.
Oh, yeah.
Now let's segue from that
to
not only worked with one legendary musician, Stevie Wonder, but you worked with Ray Charles as well as
Absolutely.
A Raylette. So how did you end up being a Raylette?
Oh my. Well,
who is that with that phone? Cut that phone off.
Is that
the wonder of public technology.
Put that bad boy on silent.
Look behind me.
No, I was going to say, Siri's trying to get on air, too.
I know.
See, I wasn't going to call Kristen out, Scherrie.
Oh, fun.
We love you, Kristen.
We do love you, Kristen. You know that.
She was so hard.
So back to Susaye.
Yeah. Well, once again, my mom. My mom was such a tremendous influence in my life. She was my first coach. She taught me the first classical pieces. She had a master's in music. You know, she was a brilliant
musician.
She was
brilliant.
Yeah, she really was. She had her own hit in 1948, a song called Honey, 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 which was the first song that Ray Charles recorded.
Really?
Just to show you the circle.
Wow.
Both he and Stevie Wonder were at her funeral.
So that was destined for you.
No
doubt.
We went to Ray's studio because our friend D. Irvin sang, what was the song? Do you like to swing on a stump? That was his song.
Really?
Yes. And Dee, at that time, was running Ray's publishing. So he said, Ray's looking for someone right now. He's missing a girl, and he's trying to put together a new group. Will you come down to the studio? So I walked in the studio with the 18-piece band. You know, we're talking about consummate professionals. But, you know, I came from New York.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I was taught to hang out with the big boys, you know. So I handed them my charts, and I started singing. And I went to work that night.
Wow.
We were at the Coconut Grove.
Wow. And, ooh, I ain't heard the Coconut Grove
in a long time. Wow. What a fabulous room.
Yeah.
And you look out there, and Barbara Streisand was there. There are all these people, and I'm... It's little me, you know.
Sherry's like, I haven't heard this story.
I'm just as fascinated.
Like she's like, I've heard them all before, but this one's new.
But it was a tremendous honor, you know. Yeah. I'd stand backstage and I'd listen every night to this man whom they call the genius for all the right reasons.
Mm.
He's absolutely brilliant. Mm. I learned from him so much more up until his death. You know, we would talk, he would call me. He was always my mentor till the very end of his life, you know.
Oh, that's beautiful.
It was a huge loss for me. Mm. I sang the Lord's Prayer at his funeral.
Yes.
And I'm sitting there. You know, it was one of the hardest days in my life.
I'm sure it was.
Sitting there, it's bad enough that it's, you know, I'm sitting there thinking, because I've always got this other conversation. Mm-hmm. He would have loved to be here to see this. He would. There's Little Richard. There's Donny Mathis, there's B.B. King, there's Willie Nelson, there's Jesse Jackson. There's all these people crying because they loved Ray.
Icons. You know,
I'm sitting next to
Cicely Tyson.
Cicely Tyson, thank you. And, you know, I'm thinking, oh, my God, that's Cicely Tyson. You know, I'm still crying, still sad. And I'm thinking, oh, my God. I reached over because I could not help myself. And, you know, she's very imperious. Mm-hmm. She's very regal. Mm-hmm. I reached over and I just patted her on the leg. And she looked horrified.
Oh,
and
I'm thinking, no.
That was Cicely Tyson. You know, when will I ever maybe get a chance to say hello? Or you know, it was such a huge part of my life. Mm-hmm. That's all I can say. With Ray, Ray taught me so much that I could not have learned otherwise, mm-hmm. because he was the same person when he came off stage, the same down-to-earth, you know, mm-hmm. just people.
Mm-hmm. And he's on one of the songs.
He sure is on Partners.
On Love Bug, that Susaye wrote.
Absolutely.
We'll have to play that one.
Please do.
We will.
Please do.
How do you, because we've met people, and amazing people in the last 6 years I've interviewed people, and some people are not as grounded as you both. Mm. How did you stay so grounded in being in this industry? Because you could have, I mean, you were divas. You are divas.
In the good sense of the word. In the good sense of the word.
Not in the modern sense of the word.
In the good sense of the word, I'm saying it loud.
When diva was good. When diva was good.
When diva was a compliment.
Yes.
Yeah, coming from the opera world.
Yeah, coming from the opera world. Because I never
played that. Incredible singers.
I never really liked the term diva because it was always sort of a negative connotation to me. But I've stayed grounded, sometimes on shaky ground, but
like the song says.
Shaky ground.
Yes, I would be that person quoting songs.
I have to say, Susaye was always an encourager for me, especially when it came to songwriting and just in general. And then my faith in Jesus Christ has grounded me. Yes. I'm a strong member of my church, First Baptist Church of North Hollywood.
Sure. All right. And you better give a shout out to the church.
Mom, I love it.
And a couple of my sister, who is Frida Payne, who sang her. Band of Golden, was a fantastic jazz singer. People just don't realize.
I know Miss Frida.
She can scat just
she
like
can
Ella.
Blow.
Yes, she can.
Yes, she can.
And just has a new jazz CD out coming out this summer. Yes,
she better shout out the Lord and her sister.
Right.
I love you for that.
My sister is bad, and she should have a star on Hollywood. I just want to say that right now. And Quincy even made some liner notes on her CD because she's known him since what she was 18 years old. He's like her mentor. But anyway, all these things combined have kept me centered. And sometimes I had to talk to myself. You know, I'd have low points where I get really down. And then I'd get a phone call or I'd read something or hear something. And bam, I'm back.
So we know that music was a huge influence for Susaye with her mom. Were your parents very influential for you and Frida?
Not one bit. My mother could not sing at all. In fact, it was like, Mama, don't sing. And our father, Fred Payne, he could not sing, but he had five sisters who had a singing group out of Asheville, North Carolina, called the Five Stars. Nobody ever heard of them. They sang their little gospel songs. It was the four sisters and a cousin. Mm-hmm. And I think maybe that's where we got our voices from. Mm-hmm. Other than that, I tell people we got them from the Lord.
See, that's what I say about with my musical thing, because there's nobody else. You know, my mom tried to sing once. Okay. I was coming through the door, and I thought, you know, and she was saying in Arabic, ta'ala, which means come here. And in a way where she sounded like she was dying, and I run in. She had headphones on. She looks at me, screams. I look at her, and I'm screaming, going, what's wrong? She's like, nothing, I'm singing. I'm like, that's not singing. You're dying.
Oh, no. Why you call out your mama like that? That's not nice.
Because I love her to death, and she loves that story.
That's hysterical. I know my mama can't sing either, bless her heart. And she always talks about how fierce my daddy is singing, and I'm like, I needed to be back during that time where I could have heard him sounding halfway decent. Because now, not so much.
Not so much. So, you know, a lot of us admire you, and we've admired your music, and especially the music you have now. But who did you admire? I know Ray, but now, who do you look up, not really look up to, but who do you think are great inspirations to the music industry today?
Ooh.
Well, I know. Growing up for me, it was Gloria Lynn and Billie Holiday. I'm really dating myself, but I don't care. I loved Gloria Lynn.
There's no date on great musicians.
Sarah Vaughan, Lena Horne, Edie Gourmet, Nat King Cole, but I loved Marvin Gaye.
But you see, those people lived and breathed music, and they studied the greats who were before them, and they knew how to to write, and they knew the instruments. Nowadays, you just go, you have a half decent voice, and as we're saying, someone auto-tunes you, writes you a cute melody that you've heard a million times before, and it's a hit for like 5 minutes, and then
which brings me to this: how do you feel about how the industry, because the industry's changed drastically from when you guys were growing up and at the height of everything from then to now? How do both of you feel about how the industry has changed?
Some good
and
some
about
bad.
Being back out there again with all those changes going on.
You know, the thing about being in show business is you have to have contact with the world. You do. You have to know what's going on. The fact of what's there with technology, the resources, the tools that are there for every artist is the great playing field, the great evening field. And it means it's anybody's game. Every artist, classic, new, whatever. If you have your music, you make your music, and we all know you can make it at home on Pro Tools. You can do whatever
you need.
Make it on
an iPad.
There you go.
iPhone.
You can do what you have to do. And then it's your responsibility to get a Twitter, to get a Facebook page, to get Instagram, to get all the different things that are resources. Free resources. The record companies. I don't think so. I don't think it's too
She's
much.
She's prolific at it. I'm a dinosaur.
Well, we're gonna change that, Miss Scherrie.
It's just attractive to me.
I love
paint,
it too.
Do a lot
so
of other
good
things.
At that. She's so good at that.
I just love it. It means that a classic artist who was, who was able to see music change, has the ability to put their music online and bring their audience to
them.
As opposed
to going out on the road and pulling.
But you can do that too.
You can do it or not.
Exactly.
You have a choice. Whereas back in the day,
there was no social media
in order to promote your CD or your
that's
album,
right.
whatever.
And
the
there
case
was no YouTube for people to put
right.
stuff on.
Right. You
if
had to
if
go
you
out.
Didn't go out, that's it.
You had to go out and promote your album.
But that's why. But that's also part of the growth. You were able then to go and engage an audience and really hone your craft rather than
that's still the best
bit.
Reaching contact in the people, seeing the people's eyes, seeing the reactions.
Yeah, exactly.
That's still the best stuff.
Absolutely, absolutely. You talk about current artists. I do like Robin Thicke.
He's really good.
He's very talented.
Very talented, and he can really sing. I love this new song. So if Paula doesn't come back to him, I'll take you, Robin.
Okay, Robin Thicke.
I'm old enough to be
if
your
you
mother.
Listening, boo, Robin Thicke, if you listening, Miss Scherrie Payne got a proposition out on the table here.
What do they call that, a cougar?
I'm old enough to be your mother.
I love that.
Miss Scherrie Payne is owning up to her cougarness, honey.
Show him how to sing.
Own it. Own it, girl. I am not mad at you for that.
Sure. So there are a lot of good artists. There are good artists out there. I love Dwele.
Okay.
There's so many, greats. Angie Stone.
She's amazing.
Erykah Badu. There are a lot of people.
Adele
is a fantastic singer.
I think she was a breath of
fresh
air.
Sam Smith.
Adele.
Out of England.
Yeah, right.
Just terrific
artist.
I love Rain out of Korea.
Corinne
South
Bailey
South
Ray
Korea.
Is also.
Oh, come on. I love Corinne Bailey Ray.
Corinne Bailey Ray is lovely.
You go on YouTube.
Beautiful, simple voice. But
Rain B.
Rain B.
And what's
B-I means rain.
Okay, I'll have to check.
Do y'all like lettuce? Yeah. I love lettuce.
I love lettuce.
Lettuce
yeah.
can go.
Yes, she can.
I like broccoli. I don't like lettuce.
Oh, stop it.
You so ignorant. I can't stand you.
It's good, though.
She's always like, I'm just a country boy.
He's always like, I'm just a country boy.
Country boy.
So as a country boy from Kansas.
Who's the singer who did the HBO number one detective agency?
Jill Scott.
She's a poet. To me, she's a poet.
She is. She started out doing spoken word.
Really? Because I love the way she writes.
Yes. Yeah, she's like a Maya. I think Maya D'Angelo. I think she's the of the songwriter.
Right, yes. And so, a wonderful actress, too.
Yes, absolutely.
So let's flip it around, y'all, and talk about July 5th.
Yeah.
What's happening on July 5th?
The Sheraton Gateway Hotel by LAX at 6 p.m.
Party going
Supreme
on there.
Supreme Partners Live, July the 5th.
Our pink
carpet starts at 5:45 for those who want to come out and, you know, showboat a little bit.
I love the fact that y'all got a pink carpet. I kind of love that. Yes. And Charlotte Crossley is opening for y'all. Yes. She was in 20 Feet. You were in 20 Feet from Stardom, too.
Yes, indeed. Academy Award.
Yes. Yes. Wow. So for those of you that don't know 20 Feet from Stardom, I reviewed that on Carlos Corner.
Oscar winning. Yes.
I reviewed that here first on Carla's Corner. Go Carla. And I brought in Edna Wright was in talking about 20 Feet from Stardom. Mm-hmm. And I'm really good friends with Lisa Fisher. We sang background together a couple of times.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Wow. Aren't you blessed?
I know, right?
She is.
Miss Lisa,
fabulous.
She is like the queen bee of background.
Yes, she is. Phenomenal.
She is fierce.
Yes, Miss Kristen.
Tata.
Oh, and Tata Vega. Tata was here, too. Yeah. Tata's been here, too.
Yes, I spoke to Tata.
Oh, okay. Hey, big shout out to Miss Tata.
Tata, I love you.
This is Tata Vega, and you're listening to On Air with Tony Sweet. Now, don't you go away.
There we go. Tata, so we're going to have to have you guys do one for us.
I love Tata.
Now, what is this event on July 5th benefiting?
Well, it is benefiting Children's Initiatives,
okay,
and it's about New Directions, which is a veterans part of the Veterans Association.
Okay,
oh, love that.
We're veterans big in our hearts.
Yes, mm-hmm.
We got family. Mm-hmm. We're lifetime careers in the Air Force and the like. So I have a big place in my heart for the vets. And as people come, you know, we have a lot of interest as women who are peace-loving women. We are mothers, wives, family, you know, we're concerned with women issues.
Yes.
Concerned with peace, mm-hmm. which brings me to Bryant McGill. Bryant McGill is our special guest, who is an activist and best-selling writer who is going to give away 500 books. He and I created the peace treaty. It's mm-hmm. called the Goodwill Treaty for World Peace.
Mm-hmm.
And we have over 125,000 signers now.
That is great.
Oh, yeah.
So where is there a link or something?
Absolutely.
If people are interested in signing
it? Sure. You can go to peacetreaty.org. Mm-hmm. You can go to bryantmcgill.com.
And Bryant is spelled B-R-Y-A-N-T.
McGill, M-C, capital G-I-L-L. And you can find, just such wonderful Simple Reminders. You can go to simplereminders.com. Bryant has a post that has become one of the most shared posts in history of Facebook.
Wow.
Because he talks about things that people need, which are inspiration and uplifting and
mm-hmm.
encouragement.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just, you know, you reach out in the web, you find people come back to you when you help to uplift them.
Mm-hmm.
That's
right.
What it's all about. That's Love what that. We're about.
Yes. That's
you
right.
You can also go to www.goodwilltreaty.org.
Thank
Goodwilltreaty.org. Yes. And for ticket purchases, you can call 213-494-1291. And that's 213-494-1291 to purchase your tickets today, and you get a $15 discount. There are general admission tickets as well as VIP table seating tickets, yes. And I also want to mention that addressing women's issues as far as breast cancer survivors, I am one.
Yes.
Oh,
I had
well,
my surgery 3.5 years ago.
Me too.
Congratulations, My mom and dad. My mom and dad are both veterans, so and my mom is a breast cancer survivor, so thank you for doing
so
that.
So dear.
Yeah.
And my mother
yeah.
passed from breast cancer when she was 56, so
she was young.
Dear, yes, she was. So
and today's my mama's 75th birthday.
It is.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, mama.
What's her name?
Patricia Sweet.
Patricia, happy birthday to you.
Oh.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Patricia. Happy birthday to you.
I'm gonna. I bet
you gonna send that to his mama.
My mama's gonna love that. Cause she was, you know, she's the one that introduced me to the Supremes.
Oh wow!
Yeah, she. Because my mom was born and raised in California.
Okay.
My dad was a country boy from Kansas. They met in the military.
No.
So growing up, I got the best of both worlds. My dad, I was Bing Crosby, you know, and the country, you know, Ernest Tubbs and all that stuff. Then my mama was the Beach Boys and the Supremes and Tina Turner. Wow. And I got the best of both worlds.
Sounds like it.
That's when people are like, how do you know all these, bands and singers? I'm like, you know. But thank you for singing that to her. I really appreciate it. I really do.
And speaking of tickets, Sydney has something that he wanted to...
Sydney going to tell us some
good news. Like to give away two tickets for the first, actually the 10th caller. We don't want the first caller. We want the 10th caller to call in and get two free tickets to the event.
How about the first and
10th? Okay, the first and
10th. First and 10th. So if you want to call in for some free tickets, it's 323-284-7826. And you want to call in and maybe ask a question and maybe get a little ticket or two. All right, we'd love to take them. If not, you know, definitely we can get you some, maybe on Twitter. We can maybe have them. And the Twitter, I think I have it here at Supreme Partners. Supreme Partners.
Live.
That's your
Kristen just corrected me.
Yeah, your SupremePartnersLive.com is your website, and then at Supreme Partners is your Twitter.
Exactly.
I get it right?
I told you I'm computer illiterate.
She said, don't listen to Scherrie.
I'm a dinosaur, I admit it. I'm a computer illiterate.
Well, you're a good looking dinosaur if you
are. Girl, you can out sing any dinosaur I know.
Okay.
And people in the chat room are actually putting up the websites that you guys have been promoting. Oh, okay. So thank you guys in the chat room. They're very active and that. So before we go, I don't want to get you off here yet, but I'm gonna see if you would participate with us.
Yeah.
So for people in the chat room and people tuning in for the first time, you have a chance to win some money. Okay. We've had some people win, and then there's some days you don't get squat.
Just doesn't happen, right?
Yeah. So I'm going to have our lovely ladies. You can either choose a California Lucky Life or Wheel of Fortune. Ooh. Which ones do you want?
I'll take that.
Let me get you a coin or a quarter here.
So on just one of them?
Susaye has one more than
you guys just scratch them all, because otherwise my co-host will just take them. I know they won't share.
Why you put that on me?
I know, right? What the hell did I do?
Thank you.
So you guys scratch those off. All of them off. And we're going to take a quick break with one of your songs. What was the song that Ray sang?
Love Bug.
Love Bug.
Let me find that, because, all right, Love Bug. We're going to play Love Bug. This is with Ray Charles singing with our lovely guest today.
Yes.
So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. On our Tony Sweet on UBN Radio. And maybe somebody's going to win.
Whoop, whoop.
I said, love bug, give me time. Then he started to laugh. He said, love bug, it's out of season.
That's right.
Don't give me that jab. The love bug is known for being easy.
What?
Saw a tear in his eye. Said, don't cry, sugar, didn't mean it. But I broke his face, and he was feeling out of place.
Well, I
he
know.
Felt that somebody was doing him wrong when I was merely singing my song. His little wings were beating so fast. I'll put up a whisper, singing love bug, give love. A little pat on his head, I said, love bug, give it to me.
Well,
then he started to dance and say, the little fella sure can boogie. With a wink of his eye, he sprinkled love around and disappeared, never saying why. First his hair is gone, he's up and running. Head. I said, love bug, give me tummy. Then he started to dance and say, the little fella shaking boogie.
Look
with a wink of his eye, he sprinkled love around and disappeared, never saying bye. First his hair is gone, he's up and running. Bye, 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 bye.
with On Air with Tony Sweet, only on Universal Broadcasting Network.
Hey there. Hey there. Welcome back to On Air with Tony Sweet. I'm his co-host, Carla Bernada, along with Whale Benali.
Hello, hello, hello.
We are here finishing up our stellar interview with the lovely Miss Scherrie Payne and Susaye Greene.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes, they've been here talking about their upcoming CD or track that's out called Partners. And it's on Amazon.com, yes?
Yes, it is.
And they are doing a benefit for the veterans on July 5th here in Los Angeles. So you want to check that out. And we've been talking about all kinds of stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Before we went to the break, Scherrie, you were talking about women's rights and whatnot. Yes. I just want to ask you this one question before we wrap it up. How do you feel about that recent Supreme Court ruling today, the one that says that if a corporation decides based on their religious
belief,
yeah, that they don't want to pay for women's contraceptives, they don't have to?
Well, I really think it's subjective. I think it's a personal choice. I think you should have the option if you want to, and if you don't want to, then just don't do it. Don't use it. I don't know.
It's unfair, though.
Yeah.
If men were the subject, then it would be different.
This is what I said earlier. I said Viagra is paid for.
It won't cover contraception.
This is ridiculous. It's ridiculous.
Yeah. You know, there's a lot of screwy things.
Yeah. if they cover it, then you don't have to use it. If you don't want to use it.
But what they're saying is that they've allowed them to say we're not going to cover it.
Any private company. It's not a corporation.
It's a family company owned.
Any private corporation has the right to say, no, we're not going to help you pay for that.
Mm-hmm. I don't think that's a good thing.
It's because of religious belief. That's what it is for.
But family companies.
It's just privately owned companies, not corporations, but privately owned companies.
There are a lot of women's issues that aren't addressed because it's about women.
Right.
You know, we know the truth. It's not an even playing field.
No, it isn't.
Not at all.
Women still struggle. Mm-hmm. You know, there is no real women's struggle.
Right.
I'm in the sense of an organized, like, women's lib. Mm-hmm. You know, I was fortunate or unfortunate enough to have lived through all of that, depending upon your perspective. But I've seen a lot of inroads for women, and yet the basic things, I mean, women are still the primary carers of children.
Yes, they are.
They can work 12 hours a day, and you still have to go home and cook dinner and take care of your kids. Mm-hmm. You know, so it's a great shame.
And unequal pay.
Mm. Absolutely.
Absolutely, yeah. That still hasn't been rectified.
I think women should make more than ages ago.
Sure.
Did I make a friend out of that?
Yeah.
Except for Oprah.
Exactly.
She makes more than anyone else. Sure.
I think young women, though, have the right idea. Women from our generation believed in being nice. Mm. You were taught to not get angry, not to move out of your space, basically. These young women march in and kick the door in, and that's what has to be done. Mm-hmm. That's the only way it's going to change.
Yep, yep. Mm-hmm.
But isn't it amazing if a young, strong woman goes in, she's deemed a bitch.
She's the bitch.
Yeah, but if a man does that,
he's assertive.
Yes.
He's a leader.
We're going to have
that. He's a
winner. That hasn't changed.
He's a winner.
I know. We're going to have y'all come back.
Yes, please.
This was fabulous. Y'all need to come and co-host or something.
Please do. We'd love to do that.
So give us all your links. Kristen, you want to give the links? Because you know.
Yes. Come on.
Let Miss Scherrie do it.
www.supremepartnerslive.com. You can find the ladies on Instagram. They are Supreme Partners. Mm-hmm. They are Scherrie and Susaye on Facebook.
And our individual sites.
Right, and they have their own. Scherrie Payne and Susaye Greene have their own pages on Facebook. And on Twitter, they're Supreme Partners. But for information, up-to-date information on everything they're doing, all of their interviews, hopefully we'll get this one too.
Oh, yes.
It's www.supremepartnerslive.com.
Thank you, Miss Kristen.
Yes, and Kristen Wright Matthews.
We want to thank you ladies for coming out to talk with us today. Thanks to Sydney and Chris and Kristen for showing up. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And we'll have y'all back. Get out there, y'all, July 5th to see the Supreme Partners.
Ma'am.
Scherrie Payne and Susaye Greene. Thank y'all.
Sheraton Gateway, LAX.
6 p.m.
All right, we're going to take another break with another song, another life. From now. All right, don't go anywhere. On Air with Tony Sweet on UBN Radio. Here we go.
There will be no turning back. We'll plan every step we make with no mistakes. Another life from now. Trouble.
with On Air with Tony Sweet, only on Universal Broadcasting Network.
Okay, we're back. Well, I'm back. Carla and Well are still out there talking, so it's just me. Look, little old me. Thank you for listening to On Air with Tony Sweet. There's Well. We were just having a good time out there with our lovely guest, and I hope you guys, if you're in the local area, go see them this Saturday. Yeah, Saturday. On Friday, I will not be here. Well, are you going to be here on Friday with
no.
Eddie? Okay. Oh, no. So when do you leave?
Saturday.
So I won't be here this Friday, but Eddie will. Eddie is going to host his own show, On Air with Tony Sweet Special. It's going to be Eddie Connor and three other psychics, which I think you probably...
Yeah, it's better if I'm not here.
I was going to say, yeah, you probably don't want to come. But
I'm going to be like the
odd man out. Yeah, the odd man out. But it's Eddie's going to be amazing with these three
Absolutely.
Psychics. If you want any like readings or whatever, these guys are going to be amazing. And of course, Eddie's going to do his segment, Girl, Your Soul is Speaking. Oh, and we're going to do Carla's Corner, but we got to set it up and get ready.
He said, Eddie's going to be doing the show on Friday. Are you going to be here? And I'm like, no, because I'm traveling Saturday, I think. And he's like, oh, yeah. So Eddie's going to be here with three other psychics. And I'm like, and you want me to be here?
No.
Yeah, I think you'll be fine.
I think not. Yeah. I think that would be a negative.
You're like, and no. And scene.
And scene.
As much as I love them all.
Yeah, but I hope you tune in and support him. I'm going to be celebrating.
I'm definitely going to be listening in.
Yeah, I'm going to be listening in, too. I'm going to be in Kansas celebrating my mama's birthday, and I can't wait to play her this amazing singing along with Scherrie. What the hell is that?
It was a voicemail that keeps coming
Scherrie
up.
Scherrie and Susaye. So we want to appreciate them. So Carla, let me get this set up.
All right.
For Miss.
So while you're getting it set up, I'll just give a brief little.
Summary.
So we have.